G'day, ajmahari here. Can you, as the ex of someone with borderline personality, can you lash out in a reverse Hoover and help to ease your pain? Can you lash out and hurt the person, the ex with BPD? Not really. And you're more likely to hurt yourself even more because the reason for the wanting to lash out, among all the reasons you might think of or be most aware of, is that you want them to see what they did to you. You want them to get how much they hurt you. You didn't deserve it. You want to be seen and heard. To reverse Hoover, to get try to get a person with BPD, an ex, or in any other relationship type person with BPD, to see your pain, to hear your agony, to validate your experience, to take responsibility for what they've done to you. It's like putting your head into the mouth of a very hungry tiger. You're going to regret it. It's going to hurt you even more. You hurt enough already, and it's time to start focusing on you and dealing with how are you going to heal from this, and what other healing work to heal codependency in the wounded inner child do you need to do for you, so you can be seen and heard and validated and able to be with yourself and soothe yourself and have a healthy relationship to and with yourself and heal what is not only the not being seen and not being heard, them not getting how much they hurt you, but likely has the footprint echo of what happened and wounded you in young childhood as well. It's really important that you don't follow any emotional impulse to lash out, whether it's email or whatever way that you would reverse Hoover to try to get that borderline back for how much they've hurt you. Because think about what's motivating that very strong feeling, that very strong impulse, that anger, that just out of agony, it's like, but they don't know what they did to me. They don't take responsibility. They don't care. I hurt so much. This is so unfair. It's so cruel. It's beyond the pain there that you're feeling. And women feel it too. And women go through really rough times in these situations too. But I just want to say to men, I work with so many male clients. Not all men are the same. And some men get more in touch with their feelings more easily. But sometimes, after you've been this wounded by someone, male or female, but again, to men, it's really hard to get in touch with those feelings. Some women, but more men, will actually be having a freeze response. And it may be your initial freeze response from what wounded your inner child as well. And many clients, some female, many male clients that I've worked with over the last 30 years that I'm working with now, really come to the process of starting to heal and recover, do the inner child healing work, family of origin, self-differentiation, and much more from a place of being able to articulate a lot about what happened and what hurts, but not really in touch with their emotions. So it's really important that you realize that that desire, that impulse, that strong protective feeling to lash back out and to say, look what you did to me, to be seen and to be heard. Like maybe you weren't seen and heard as a child either. There's a duality of that. And then there's a reality that people with BPD, especially untreated, your ex, a sibling, your parent, they're responsible for hurting you and devastating you. But you can't make them see it. So you don't get seen, and you don't get heard, and you don't get validated. And it builds, and it builds, and you ruminate, and you ruminate, and you don't know what to do with all this feeling or the anger that's protecting your vulnerable, devastated, shattered emotional landscape of incredible pain. And pain, again, that I want you to realize and think about, that a part of you has been holding pain similar to the pain from the BPD-X since you were a child. the seeds of codependency. And so for men, I want to reiterate, vulnerability is not a weakness. And this pain and this devastation that you're in right now, you want to lash out, you want to reverse Hoover. And there might be lots of other feelings going on, like you want to get back with him, you want to try again. It was the best way you were ever loved, even though you realize now it wasn't really love. What you need to know is that you matter way more than that. And that any efforts to lash out or reconnect or try to find closure are really, in a codependent sense of what you're going through, they're your ways of trying to protect yourself from turning into your pain. The pain from the relationship, the not being seen, the not being heard, and the pain of the wounded inner child in you. And men, often in their families of origin, are taught that it's weak to feel. And culture still supports that. So men, not all, but many, have a harder time getting through the anger, getting through a lot of emotions that surround and protect you from the core, which is the inner child healing work as well. The core of going down deep to very vulnerable pain. So if you're a man listening to this, I just want you to know, when I work with men, it is a sacred honor to help men to access that pain and to always be very aware and very validating and encouraging to men to realize and understand that you may have been inculcated by culture and or your family of origin to think that vulnerability is weakness. But I've been working with clients recently, men who have never opened up before, and they're opening up now. And there's a trust there, and we build that trust, and we foster that trust. They need to trust me. People that work with me need to trust me. And men need to know that all the reasons why you want to lash out, get back, go back, be heard again, be seen again, the physicality of it all of it is to cover up this pain that you may well be aware of, but not exactly feeling in totality, in the sense of opening up to your vulnerable feelings, because many men are in a freeze response, and many men learned that in childhood as little boys. And many men have still, between family of origin and culture, like I said, you want them to get how they hurt you. And yet at the same time, it's so conflicting because you don't want to look weak, don't want to feel humiliated, you don't want to embarrass yourself. And men need to know that you too deserve to feel not only the feelings of the pain of what you've just been through with a person with BPD in your life in any relationship type, but specifically a significant other. But men really need to know that you have a wounded inner child in there, a little boy inside. And maybe he didn't know how to cry. Maybe he wasn't allowed to cry. And maybe today you carry that freeze response of the protection of anger and other feelings like shame and humiliation. You're in touch with those. Many men do cry. Many men aren't able to access the crying. Many men stay in the protection of anger. It's different for every man out there. But I just want you to know, what men need to learn in this sacred healing process is that your vulnerability is every bit as much a strength as is the vulnerability of women. And not all women are the same, but many women can access vulnerability more readily because culture supports that. And that's the big difference that I see between men and women. Not all men and not all women. But so it's really important to know that the wanting to lash out is really about what you most need to turn to yourself and working with someone, like myself if I resonate with you, but working with someone, whoever you choose to work with, that can help you to really get into the feelings, get in and through and heal the pain and the devastation and the duality of the woundedness. So lashing out is only going to hurt you more, because they won't see you, they won't hear you. And maybe as a child you weren't, or sometimes, or maybe most of your childhood in growing up, maybe you had the kind of mother that did a good job in many ways, or maybe didn't at all, but wasn't emotionally available, that you maybe didn't really feel safe with or couldn't really connect to, So it's really important, this desire, to know that this desire, this want, this strong impulse to lash out, to get them, to get it, is the last thing that will help you with your pain. And it's so important to radically accept that now you're responsible for your pain and your recovery journey, not what they did to you. What they did to you is not okay. But now the journey is yours. And the growth opportunity and the chance of a lifetime, which it's not going to feel like that right now, but to really not only heal from the relationship, but to heal the little boy, and for women, the little girl inside that's wounded and that so needs all that overgiving, caring, such you've been doing for somebody with BPD. That little child inside you needs you. And you need that little boy or that little girl. That connection has to happen. Healing has to happen. The last thing you need is to be lashing out. The last thing you need is to be recontacting, staying in contact, getting further hurt, getting in the comparative narrative, but now they're with another man or woman, because none of that reflects on you. It's about you and your pain right now, and the crisis of all that, and the growth opportunity it presents you. That right now, it likely doesn't feel like at all. But the way I work with clients, they learn how to process. They process, we do the deeper work, and they realize the silver lining in this otherwise incredibly wounding, devastating, shattering experience of the way that somebody with BPD treated you, which for many, for so many, mirrors what happened with a parent or parents to one degree or another that so wounded your inner child. So this, in all of its devastating pain, the anger, the shame, the humiliation, the woundedness that you want to reach out, that you want them to know what they did, start with you know what they did. Start with you know how you feel. And you might not know what to do with that at all. But that's what I'm out here to help those who resonate with me to work on, to start to heal, to embrace what is the most painful experience of your life, perhaps, or the secondary one in terms of depending on what is held in your wounded inner child. But it is also, and it won't feel like it right now, an amazing growth opportunity to finally get to know yourself fully, to heal the dysfunctional relationship to and with self of being a codependent, and to learn your way through the healing to a healthy relationship with yourself, to self-love and self-care. And that will blow the doors open on your going forward in your life and on healthier relationships and on anything and everything that you've ever wanted in a relationship with the significant other, that man or that woman. And doing anything but this work and this healing is selling yourself short. And many people are afraid, and truthfully, many more men are afraid. But you need to feel the fear and get into the healing and recovery process regardless of the fear. And know that your anger and your want to lash out right now is reach out to me if you resonate with me. Reach out to someone else if you choose to work with someone else. And in the meantime, try to be okay with how you feel, even when it feels like you can't stand it. Because it's going to show you a new relationship with yourself in healing. It's going to show you the way forward. And the way forward is all about you, precious you, what you need to heal so you can achieve your relationship goals and dreams, whether that includes a family, etc., wherever you are in the course and stage of your life. But lashing back out or focusing on them anymore is only keeping you stuck from the sacred journey back to self and to healing from the relationship, but to healing the wounded inner child. Don't lash out. Reach out for help. And know, if you're a man, that your pain and your vulnerability is just as valid and just as okay and just as much a strength as is a woman's pain and their vulnerability. Many, many men still need to learn that the vulnerability of your tears, of grieving your pain, of looking into the inner child work and dealing with that original woundedness is a sacred process and is one you so deserve. Nobody wants to go through it, but as you get into it, as I see clients getting into it and working through it, joy arises from the sorrow because you are freeing yourself from the woundedness and you are clearing out the pain. Don't think about them. You might ruminate still, but focus on yourself. Get into a healing and recovery process because that's so worth it. And any time and effort that you might spend lashing out, trying to rehook up, etc., with the ex is really self-abandonment, ignoring yourself, and ignoring your woundedness and that precious little boy or little girl inside who needs you so much now. Take care.